height advantage, 5'11", 5'8". This will be a fun one to see if Sam wants to keep it at range and see if Alan, who's wooing to the crowd.
Well, they're both definitely feeding off of each other's energy right now, that's for sure.
Sam needs to get his hands up. Nice jab by Sam. What I'd like to see Sam do is pump that jab. Just pump it, pump it, pump it. Because being a longer fighter like that, that gets really, really annoying. And then you start seeing what they're going to do. Good leg kick out of Sam. Set that kick up with a couple punches there. Oh, they're trading leg kicks. This is not going to be fun.
Boy, these guys are going to wake up with sore legs tomorrow morning.
Absolutely. The thing I hated most was leg kicks. You deal with them, but then they deal with them again for about 2 more weeks.
Keep on reliving the memory. It's the gift that keeps on giving, Adam.
Absolutely. And these guys are here to give these fans what they want. A little bit of a low blow right there, snuck up there from Sam Coronado.
Apparently no pain, no gain. I think he gave her some sincere apology there, but... Whoa, that one hurt.
Nice outside kick out of there by Alan.
Boy, they're trading really well right here. I don't think either one of these guys is interested in sitting on the mat at all.
Not at all. Sam's got a little mouse under that left eye.
Boy, a lot of action right here. What's really getting to me right now, Adam, is the eye contact. Neither one of these guys is interested in backing down from each other at all.
Ooh, that right hand split him open a little bit on the bridge of the nose.
Yeah, it sure did. Boy, they are going at it. Another nice shot.
These guys are trying to get that HKA fight of the night bag.
Inside right now, and
ooh.
Neither man is... Ooh, oh, my goodness.
Oh, that right eye is messing with him. He's messing up with Alan.
And right nice now, he shot. Is quenching up that left eye a whole lot. It could turn into target practice here in a moment. It sure did. Oh, firing back, though.
Nice.
And they're finally on the ground.
Nice double leg takedown. And right here, what you see Sam doing is something I took from Zach that I really like, a leg lace. You see him trying to lace those legs up. It's kind of infamously Khabib Nurmagomedov's kind of a signature, right? And now he can't do it. Now he's just pinned him against the cage. But look, Alan is bleeding all over out of the nose and the mouth.
And he's still having a hard time with that left eye. We've seen him keep kind of... He's trying to squeeze something out of there. It's really evident that a lot of sweat and blood is clearly getting into that eye right now.
Yeah, if I was going to guess, I'd say Sam hit him with probably a nice crisp in the right hand that caught him in the eye. You know, it wasn't an eye poke. Mike Englund would have probably caught that. He's very good at seeing those things. Jumps up. Now he has the back. Looks to get that rear naked choke in. He's trying to fight those hands in. Being a long leg, you guys, what I was talking about. You're able to lace stuff in there.
Here we go.
Drew, I'm clenching my hands here. I'm getting excited.
Oh, man, I'm telling you what. Here we go. He's trying to get Alan's it. Run 10 seconds left in what has been one hell of a round.
I think Alan's going to make it out of this round. But Sam definitely going to make it.
Oh, boy, I don't know. There we go.
What a round out of both these guys.
He is bleeding.
Yeah, look at that.
Something.
That left eye on Alan is going to swell shut.
Now, we saw him right there. It almost looked like it was going to blow his nose. And as we know from the Cerrone fight, you don't want to do that.
Yeah, you don't want to do that. Anytime you get hit in the nose, it's going to cause more damage. I give that first round to Sam, although that was very, very exciting. Both these guys are going to wear this fight by the end of the night.
I mean, clearly very active. I feel like I'm watching Rocky and Apollo Creed out there right now.
It was very, very similar. Yeah, it was a good first round, entertaining for the fans. You know, right there, I think that first round was worth the price of admission.
Boy, if you're a fight doctor, though, right now, and you're checking out Gooseman, what is your primary concern, Adam?
I want to get that blood to stop, and then I want to see what that swelling looks like on that eye. Because you don't want that eye to swell up because of broken orbital bone or anything like that. And again, we just go back to the safety of the fighters. Craig Nocello in there, one of the best cut men for Bellator. You know, bent all over the place.
Boy, they are picking up pieces and cleaning up blood out there right now. Here we go, round number two. Far different look, though, from Guzman. A lot of intensity talking about let's go beforehand. Second round, not so much, but still giving everything he's got, though.
Yeah, I think Alan Guzman's going to need to... He's clearly...
Oh, he took one there,
more.
Though. He's trying to get inside, and right now he's showing all the guts in the world, that's for sure. Just took one there.
The reason he's doing that is because you see Sam keeps his hands a little bit low. Being a taller guy like that, you're able to kind of slip out of the way. But I actually thought these guys would trade kicks a little bit more, knowing that they had some success. Sam jumps in on a double leg. He's got those legs. Hips are back. Allen with a good job getting back to the cage. Going to do what they call a DC-1 here, just place that leg and suck him down to the mat.
And here we, as part of this, sometimes maybe both fighters, hey, we've been battling the hell out of this. Let's kind of take a minute here.
No, I've never been there. Some older vets might do that. But, but no, as you look, Sam's got those legs laced up. That eliminates the hips from Allen, so he has really no way to get his base back. So he's just going to search for a guillotine here, which is really kind of stupid since he's got his back on the cage and essentially was mounted. Sam just steps to the right.
So if you're Guzman, what do you do right now then?
Right now he's trying to just lace him up. He's got a good grip on the neck. If he could, so Zach Cummings over there in the corner is actually really good at this almost like a half guard guillotine. But I don't think Allen's got it the way he needs it. And Sam being so long, he's just able to kind of stretch his body out and get some space on that neck. You hear Guzman's corner yelling to use that to get out, but it's really not the right advice there. I mean, I understand what they're saying, but he's in a bad position for that. But Guzman did a good job getting his guard back. What he needs to do is he needs to start circling his back, or, you know, get to that cage, so he can start doing what they call wall walking. So he's got to use his hips to create that space. Sam's doing a good job of holding him tight, kind of making it uncomfortable. As you see Allen's face smashed up against that cage, you make it uncomfortable, that just sucks.
And right now, a couple of good licks right there as well to the body, continuing to wear him down on top of all the damage he has clearly taken to the face. Now what's he going for here, Adam? Looks like Coronado's looking
right
to stand
here.
Up.
So Allen's going for a knee bar.
The ref is talking to him.
You can't do any heel hooks as an amateur, is what I think the rule is.
Well, it looks like Guzman was somewhat able to work his way out of it. We got 10 seconds left in the second round. Clearly not as eventful, but be that as it may, it looks to me like round number two is going to go to Sam Coronado.
Yeah, I think Sam won that round. I think Allen's a little upset that maybe he misunderstood the rules. I don't know if you can go for knee bars as an amateur nowadays. I know the rules have all kind of changed a little bit. But Sam's going to have a couple nice black eyes at the end of this. Guzman's clearly going to look like he got in a fight.
Almost looks like he got mauled by a tiger there, Adam. How is he still standing?
It's tough. That second round, Sam didn't really hit him with anything solid. That's all first round damage.
Now that first round damage is going to be around for about a month. I feel like I'm watching the first McGregor-Diaz fight. And they are again feeding off of each other. Round number three. Oh, he took one there. We sure did. And he caught him there. And that one looks like it's going to affect Coronado a little bit more than it did Guzman earlier.
Yeah, a little bit of a low blow, which really takes that momentum around. Takes that momentum down. I think Allen was coming out to.
Boy, and they just saw it again up there. The crowd did, as you can see. And that one was clear. Boy, Coronado's going to try and fight through that one. And, oh, he got up and then got right back down.
So here's the deal. He'll get up and he'll finish this round. He'll finish this fight. Because I know that Zach's going to push him and he won't let him back if he doesn't. But what that did to me, though, Allen was completely amped up and ready to rock and roll. You know, screaming, hooting and hollering, whatever you want to say. This really just brings that momentum and that pace way down. So this may work in Sam's favor. Although he did get kicked in the goodies.
Is it 5 minutes? Is that what you get?
Yeah, you get 5 minutes to recover. Man, luckily I've never been hit there in a fight to where it affected me. So, I mean, I've been hit there plenty, but not to where I ever need a 5 minute to where it ever, you know, affected me too much.
Well, for anybody wondering, this is why you wear a cup for the giblets, folks.
Yes. And the problem I always had with my cup was trying to find an adult large strap with a youth small cup to go in there. I never sold them separately, you know what I mean? Mike Yangling gets them back ready to go.
Yeah, here we go. The crowd is certainly into this one. Coronado's giving him the it's all good, partner.
I think Allen's going to try to hit that jab.
All right, here we go again.
Right hand over.
Allen continuing the taunt. He's just not backing down
right
with a couple of good shots. My goodness.
See,
Coronado wants to slow it back down to get it to the ground and put it back in
nice
his favor.
Takedown.
Yeah, but he's giving him some good licks here right now, though.
Absolutely he is. So here's the deal. If you notice, every time Guzman hits that a good overhand right, Sam gets in on that takedown and then takes it where he's comfortable.
Yeah. Working him hard up against the cage.
I'm going to back it up a little bit. I don't want any blood on me.
Remember last time, man, it dropped right in our lap. Yeah, it did. Boy, he is bleeding profusely, folks.
Sam's got to get that other
hook. Ah, he's blown it out a little bit.
He got that other hook. Now
he sure does.
Gives a thumbs up to everybody.
Boy, this one, maybe it goes a distance, maybe it doesn't. If it does, clearly fight of the night, and even if it doesn't.
I am going to give it fight of the night so far, obviously.
How do you counter this right now if you're Guzman out and somebody's just laying on your back like that from up top?
Well, you're going to try to break that grip. And what I mean by that grip is the legs laced in there like that. You see the long legs laced around and on the inside. That's just grapevining those legs. And all that's doing is making Guzman hold you, right? But what Sam needs to do is he needs to try to break that grip and get that choke in there and advance his position.
And you heard the referee telling Coronado right now, you're not going to rest on him like that. You're going to have to do some action as well. Look out. Look out. It could get ugly. There it goes. But the guy put himself in an even worse position though by doing that.
He absolutely did. But you got to think, you know, big risk and big reward. And that's why Allen is so fun to have here at Apex. He's so much fun to watch.
My goodness. He's clearly trying to get that hooked in, but it looks like...
really good defense. Sam needs to do right here is lock his hands in a gable grip, and then he'd stretch him out. He'd be able to stretch him a little bit more, and then wiggle that hand under that neck a little bit.
Well, he was just exchanging one arm for the other, it seems like, though.
Yeah, we're on a short time anyway, so I think Allen's just trying to wait it out. Although I think he's clearly losing the decision.
Round number three in what has been one incredible fight. A little bit of a slowdown pace here right now, but Coronado's just trying to end it, it looks like. He may be able to do it. Nope, Guzman able to get out of it again, but, boy, he's just spitting everywhere, hawking it all over the place.
Yeah, we got it on our table right here. It's kind of disgusting.
It's just blood, Adam. You've had it on you before.
Yeah, but it's
cold. There it is, folks. Well, they really are just embracing everything about each other.
Look at Guzman's left leg. He's got a nasty cut on that. I guess they probably might have went like shin to shin or something, but he's got a nasty cut on that left leg.
Who do you give that fight to, Adam?
Sam Coronado, 3-1, no problem. No way. Or anything, you know, no other way than that. And so far, that is the runner-up for fight of the night, which the HKA sponsorship bag. And Drew, I gotta tell you, man, you know, all these fights are fantastic and everything, but at the end of the day, I'm a retired person. I keep seeing everybody with these nachos walking around here in the Ivy Arena. Man, I'm gonna have to give you some nachos.
Are you supposed to be in training for some jiu-jitsu you got coming
up? Yeah,
out?
I do have jiu-jitsu in March, but I'll be all right.
What's one thing a nacho's gonna hurt?
These pants are pretty tight as they are. I'll start tomorrow. New year, new me.
on the 15th?
What?
On the 15th?
Yeah.
You're not the same person you were 10 minutes ago.